For nearly 30 years, Canada's Métis have struggled to forge a Métis Nation constitution. From the Métis governing bodies in Ontario, Manitoba, Saskatchewan, Alberta, and BC to unite under a new constitution as one Métis Nation would assure that Métis, no matter where they are in Canada, that they'd be able to assert inherent rights to self-government as recognized under Section 35 of the Canadian Constitution. Still, the challenge remains how to get there. The Métis National Council Policy Conference, held in late March 2016, was aimed at moving a step closer toward lifting existing roadblocks.
Right now, we've got a patchwork of rights because we're in a federal state where provinces control some of the powers and the feds control others. And because of our landless existence, we are, at the moment, subject to those provincial regulatory regimes, whether it's rights management, harvesting, whatever it is. And the duty to consult.
Métis are included as one of the Aboriginal peoples of Canada under Section 35 of the Constitution Act 1982. The definition of a Métis person, as adopted by the Métis Nation, is someone who self-identifies as Métis, is distinct from other Aboriginal peoples, is of historic Métis Nation ancestry, and who is accepted by the Métis Nation. For years, Métis have been a political hot potato that neither the provinces nor the federal government wanted to take responsibility for dealing with the Métis. On April 14, 2016, the debate was finally put to rest when the Supreme Court of Canada in Daniels versus Canada affirmed that Canada has a constitutional and jurisdictional responsibility to deal with the Métis Nation and its people with roots stemming from the historic Métis Nation homeland. One of the key debates which needs to be overcome in moving forward towards a Métis Nation constitution is the five governing regions need to agree on the historic Métis Nation homeland, which is currently seen as including the three prairie provinces and which extends into portions of Ontario and British Columbia. In other words, do Métis have deep historic roots going back generations throughout Ontario and British Columbia? And will the claims stand up in court?
Not until we find a formula, I think, will there be peace on this issue.
We have to remember that if we want to be a strong nation, we are one people, we have the same rights all across from nation to nation, from end to end. So we need to put our differences aside. I agree with David on that. We need to put our differences aside, but we need to tackle this in a, as Jean put it, in a way that we can defend it in courts. We need to have evidence.
While the Métis debate continued over moving ahead on a Métis Nation constitution, the federal government took its commitment to recognize and support the Métis Nation a step further. Budget 2016 included a promise of $25 million over 5 years to enhance the Métis Economic Development Strategy, which began in 2009 and was built on four pillars, including strengthening Métis Nation educational institutions, labor force skills development, business development, including access to capital and procurement opportunities, plus community participation in major projects.
I think the information we get out of Stats Canada is simply just not indicative of what the real conditions and opportunities are for Métis people. And so the discussion this morning about recognition and rights and kind of the identification of who Métis are, I think is very important to that. And moving forward on a better and a more comprehensive profile of Métis people, conditions, and opportunities would be very helpful in terms of how we design policy and how we design programs.
But I think that there is an opportunity now with a government that is willing to hear and to take into consideration larger scope and change, not just the same old framework for doing business. So that's what we're going to be doing over the next 12 months. I do not know what that structure for engagement is going to be at this point. I have not had the opportunity, nor do I think anybody in my department has had the opportunity to actually sit down with the minister on that particular issue, but it's going to have to come soon.
The release of Budget 2016 and the Supreme Court decision were followed on May 27, 2016, with the signing of a Memorandum of Understanding between Canada and the Manitoba Métis Federation. The signing established a path forward to resolve the Métis' 146-year-old outstanding land claim under the Manitoba Act of 1870, in which the federal government at the time had promised to set aside 5,565 square kilometers of land for 7,000 children of the Red River Métis, a promise that was never fulfilled. During the Métis National Council's annual General Assembly in Winnipeg on June 16, 2016, the MNC issued a news release which read, "In the fighting spirit of Cuthbert Grant and his Métis Defense Force, who defeated the Selkirk settlers in the Hudson's Bay Company at the Battle of Seven Oaks on June 19, 1816, a plan and timetable were developed for completing the work on a Métis Nation Constitution." As a part of the MNC General Assembly, a special event was held at the site of the Battle of Seven Oaks in Winnipeg to commemorate the historic event which saw the first raising of the Infinity Flag and the emergence of a new nation, the Métis Nation, which continues to this day to fight for Métis rights under the same Infinity Flag. In fall 2016, Métis policy experts will begin to draft a Declaration of Rights and Principles of the Métis Nation, with a final version of the Métis Nation Constitution to be presented for approval at the next MNC General Assembly in 2017. The Constitution would help strengthen the Métis Nation as it heads into reconciliation talks with the federal government. Helping to solidify the Métis Nation's growing drive for recognition was a long-awaited report from a ministerial special representative to the Federal Minister of Indigenous and Northern Affairs. Lawyer Tom Isaac was asked to study Métis inherent rights under Section 35 and fulfilling the Government of Canada's commitments under the Manitoba Métis land claim. His report, which was well received by the Métis governing bodies, called for a fundamental change in the way the federal and provincial governments deal with and respect Métis as Section 35 rights holders. Métis National Council President Clément Chartier says ever since the new government came to power, the Supreme Court ruling and now the Isaac Report, the floodgate has opened with numerous invitations to engage with the Métis Nation on a myriad of issues.
So going forward, the Assembly of First Nations, the Inuit Apirit Kanatami, and ourselves are going to continue meeting. We're likely going to meet in April. We're trying to come up again with this partnership agreement where we consolidate the relationship between the three representatives of Indigenous governments or Indigenous governments ourselves to consolidate that moving forward, this is the preferred way, or this is the way we will engage with the Canadian and federal government. So we're moving quite a bit forward rapidly, and basically the commitment, the policy by the Trudeau government to deal on a nation-to-nation basis is, you know, making this a lot easier now. We've been trying for so many years, but now the door is there, the opportunity is there, and it's for us to take advantage.
Under the current government in Ottawa, the Métis Nation has developed a strong and growing working relationship. However, governments change, and so to avoid a repeat of past challenges, the Métis Nation, once it adopts a constitution, will ask the federal government to pass legislation into law, recognizing the Métis Nation, so that when the next government comes into power, the Métis won't have to start from scratch.